As we said before, the second category of the changes that occur to the lease agreements after the commencement date are changes in the estimates on which the calculation of the lease payments is based, and therefore require a reassessment of the lease liability. So, they are only changes in estimates, not changes in the original contract terms. Examples of these changes include changes in the amounts expected to be payable under residual value guarantee, changes in the rates and indices on which future lease payments are based, changes in the assessment of the length of the lease term, changes in the assessment of the option to purchase the underlying asset. We saw examples for all these changes in Section 4, when we talked about the determination of the lease term, and in Section 5, Lecture 4, when we talked about the components of the lease payments, and we will see more examples in the following lecture. In case a reassessment is required, we should revise the lease payments, then remeasure the lease liability as the present value of the revised payments. This remeasurement is done using either the original discount rate that was used on the commencement date, or a revised discount rate at the date of the reassessment. If the changes were in the amounts expected to be paid under residual value guarantee, or in the rates and indices on which the future lease payments are based, then the original discount rate should be used to discount the revised lease payments. But if the changes were in the length of the lease term, or in the amounts expected to be payable under purchase option, then the revised discount rate should be used. The lessee shall determine the revised discount rate on the date of reassessment, as the interest rate implicit in the lease for the remaining lease term, if that rate can be readily determined, or the lessee's incremental borrowing rate on the date of reassessment, if the interest rate implicit in the lease cannot be readily determined. There is one exception here concerning the changes in the rates and indices on which the future lease payments are based. If the change in the future lease payments resulted from a change in floating interest rates, in this case, the original discount rate should not be used. Instead, the revised discount rate should be used to reflect the changes in the floating interest rate. After reassessing the lease liability, the right-of-use asset should be adjusted by the same adjustment done to the lease liability. In the event where the reassessment of the lease liability results in a reduction in its carrying amount, then the right-of-use asset should be reduced by the same reduction. If this reduction was greater than the carrying amount of the right-of-use asset, then the right-of-use asset should be reduced to zero balance, and any remaining reduction should be recognized in the profit or loss. Let us check the following lecture for some examples.